Suspension bridges are the most attractive structures, possessing a number of technical, economical, and aesthetic advantages. Now, before we talk about these advantages, we need to understand what is a suspension bridge. A suspension bridge is a unique type of bridge in which the deck is hung below the suspension cables by vertical suspenders. The main cables are suspended between towers and are finally connected to the anchorage. The deadweight of the deck slab and the traffic load on it carried by vertical suspenders, which are in tension and hanging from parallel cables separated by a distance approximately equal to the bridge deck width, called as main suspension cables, which are the main load carrying member made of very high strength steel. Cable bands are used to connect the suspenders with the main cable. There are two types of cable connection bands are used: wrapping bands. In this arrangement, the cable band has grooves on it to accommodate looping and wrapping of suspender over the main cable. And the other one is pinned connection bands, where the end of the suspenders are manufactured with standard zinc port sockets, and these sockets are connected with cable bands by pin rod. Cable bands are mainly used to restrict the relative displacement or slippage of suspenders in the longitudinal direction. The main suspension cables are generally made of thousands of high-tension steel wires, having a diameter ranging from 3 mm to 7 mm, which are spun together one by one at the construction site, then bundled. This arrangement of smaller diameter cables finally becomes one big cross-section suspension cable for being highly efficient in carrying the entire gigantic loads. After installation, cables are covered with high-density polyethylene sheets, and voids between the strands are completely filled with epoxy resin to prevent corrosion. The main cables are passed through the main towers with the aid of a special structure known as a saddle, and end on big anchorages that holds them on the ground at either end of the bridge. The anchor blocks resist the tensile pull from the main cable due to the loads in main span. Without these anchorages, the main towers will be subject to huge bending stresses due to the combined loads in the main span. And these towers couldn't bear the bending stresses because slenderness ratio of these towers are very high. And these can only bear axial forces, especially compressive forces. Therefore, saddles are used at the top of the main towers to clamp the cable securely at the required deflection angle. Practically, all the loads are concentrated on the saddle and transferred vertically downwards to the main towers. The main towers transfers the axial compressive loads to the huge and capable foundations and finally to the ground. As much as the suspension bridge gets longer, it becomes more flexible structure. Large deflections develops in the flexible decks, and the wind loading creates unstable oscillations. A number of early suspension bridges were designed without the appreciation of wind effects, and disaster happened. The problem has largely solved by stiffening the bridge deck with truss or girder elements to ensure the aerodynamic stability. Let us discuss some design factors of suspension bridges. Number 1. Sag ratio. The amount of sag in the main suspension cables at the center of the span is called as dip, denotes by small d. And the horizontal distance between the center line of towers is called as span, denotes by S. The ratio of dip to the span is called as sag ratio. It controls the strength and stability of the bridge. If the main cables have a flat curve, means having low sag ratio, the vertical stability will be more. Like a flat hammock is always having more vertical stability than a curvy hammock. But The stresses on the rope of the hammock will be very high in this case, as well as in the main suspension cables, and require strong anchorages apart from the towers to hold these cables. And if the sag ratio is high, there will be less stresses on the main cables. As a result, the anchorages may be placed closer to the towers. The sag ratio of a standard suspension bridge varies between 7 to 8%. Number 2. Camber. It is the vertical distance between the bottom of floor beam at the center of span to the line drawn from the bottom of floor beam at the center of towers. Camber is used to counteract deflection due to the load. This is a negative deflection of the structure, so under the load it will have the tendency to bend and become straight line, means zero deflection. Then the next tendency to have positive deflection or sagging. By this way, the arched form resists sagging and provides one kind of pre-stressing to the long span structure to bear the huge loads. The standard suspension bridges have a camber of 0.67% of the span length. Number 3. Cradle. It is the lateral distance from the midpoint of the main cable to the straight line drawn between its points of supports on the towers, denotes by K. Cradle improves the lateral stability of the suspension bridge. Usually, it is 0.6 to 5% of the span length. Number 4. Flare. It is the lateral distance from the cable support on the towers to the cables at the anchorage, denotes by F. Flare also increases lateral stability of the suspension bridge. The flare should be between 2.5 to 3.5% of the horizontal backstay length. And number 5. Backstay slope. Backstay slope is the ratio of vertical distance between the anchorage and the tower support to the horizontal distance between them. It is responsible to balance equal tensile stress in the main suspension cable on both sides of the tower. In standard suspension bridges, backstay slope is usually 1:2.5. Let's talk about the advantage and disadvantages of suspension bridges. The prime advantage is, this design is effective for very long spans because the support mechanism remains the same. China has built half of the 10 longest suspension bridges currently operational in the world. The current record holder is the 1915 Kanakale Bridge in Turkey, with a central span of 2.023 kilometers. It took 5 years to complete the construction and officially opened to the public on 18th March in the last year. Number 2. Suspension bridges are very cost-effective when compared to other designs. There is a very minimal amount of materials needed in order to construct a suspension bridge. And number 3. Suspension bridges can be built very high over waterways. This is essential for any area that needs to be able to allow passing ships to come through. Moreover, suspension bridges are recognized as the most appealing structures due to their aesthetically pleasing appearance, although heavy concentrated loads are the main problem for suspension bridges. The cables of the suspension bridge have limitations in the load resistance. That's why suspension bridges don't usually used for rail crossings. If you like this video, make sure you hit the subscribe button below and click on the bell to turn on the notification.